scoot the stand that way just a touch so it's not, yeah, there we go.
Wonderful. Now that there's nobody impeding up here. First off, I would like to thank everybody for coming to this Eagle Scout Corps of Honor for Tyler Reed. My name is David Campbell, and I am Scoutmaster for Troop 417. We are here to honor Tyler Reed in achieving the highest rank of Scouts, the Eagle Scout rank. He has gone through a lot of information or a lot of stuff to do, over 3 years of merit badges and learning skills, and so much more. So first off, may I please have Max Glembiewski come up for the color guard.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Max Glembiewski, like Mr. Campbell said. I'm a sophomore here at Upper Arlington High School, and I'm the current SBL, newly elected. And I would ask that the audience please rise, if you're able, for the presentation of the colors. Audience attention. Color guard attention. Color guard forward march. Color guard halt. Troop, please join me in the saying of the Pledge of Allegiance. Scout hand salute. If you're not in your uniform, please place your hand over your heart. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the public for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Two. Color guard, prepare to post the colors. Color guard, post the colors. Color guard, reform. Color guard, return to ranks. Color guard, hold. Color guard, at ease. Will you please all join me in the saying of the Scout Oath, Scout Signs? On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country, to obey the Scout law, to help other people at all times, keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. Please join me in saying the Scout law. A Scout is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent. Audience at ease, you may be seated.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Kevin Snyder. I'm the senior pastor here at the Mount View Christian Church, where Tyler and his family are an active and an integral part of this community of faith. I couldn't be more thrilled that Tyler chose his church to host this ceremony, not only because it's the place where Tyler performed his Eagle Scout project, but more importantly, it's a people who, in partnership with his dad and his mom, have played a role in his ongoing maturation and continued spiritual formation. On a personal note, I've known Tyler for his entire life. And better than any activity that Tyler has participated in or projects that his hands have produced is Tyler's heart. We learn in the Bible in 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 7, that while humanity has a tendency to look on man's outward appearance, what God looks on and what God cares about the most is a person's heart. So it's not what they do or how many achievements they accomplish, but who ultimately they've become. Tyler, we are thrilled today at the incredible work that we see God doing in your heart and in your life, and congratulations as you officially receive the rank of Eagle Scout. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of this day and for the opportunity to gather in this place with these people to acknowledge not merely the work that Tyler has done, but the work that you have, are, and will continue to do in and through him. God, it's easy to see you at work in him. As he receives this award today, may he see this through your eyes as a special and significant spiritual milestone that he marks along the way of growing to be a man after your own heart in all things and in all seasons. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hello, everyone. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Jed Fisher. I'm currently a freshman at OSU. I've known the Reeds since very early elementary school from scouting and other activities, and they've been wonderful, and I'm really happy to be up here at Tyler's Court of Honor today. And I wanted to talk a little bit about what it means to be a Boy Scout. The Scout Oath. This is the oath you just heard our troop recite. It is a major part of scouting. We recite this oath at every meeting, ceremony, and campout. More importantly, we as scouts are supposed to live by this oath every single day. The Scout Oath can be broken down into four duties of a scout: duty to God, duty to country, duty to others, and duty to self. Duty to God. This is the first part of the Scout Oath. A scout can accomplish this in many different ways: by being faithful to their God and following his commandments the best of their abilities. The scout is also active in their church community and respects all of God's people and creations. They also respect the belief of others, even if it goes against their own. Duty to country. This is the second point in the Scouting Oath. A scout may accomplish this by following the laws of his country and is willing to live for it as others have died. While dying for your country requires extreme courage, living for your country through the Scout Oath and law requires just as much. Just like the Scout Law says, a scout is brave. The third point, duty to others. The scout slogan, do a good turn daily, and many points of the law fall under the category of doing your duties to others. A scout is friendly and fair to anyone they come across. They're even willing to help with nothing in return. Doing something kind to others without expecting something in return. Duty to self. This means to take care of yourself, physically and literally speaking. The oath wraps up with the words, to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. The scout grows in strength, knowledge, wisdom, and spiritually. This is how they experience the joy of living. Now I invite Logan up to talk about what it means to be an Eagle Scout.
If you don't know me, my name is Logan. I am an Eagle Scout also with Troop 417. I've known Tyler since probably the first day of Boy Scouts. He's made an impact on me, and I know he's made an impact on everyone he's interacted with. The foremost responsibility of being an Eagle Scout is to live with honor. Honor is the foundation of all characters. Character is what one really is, deep down inside. An Eagle Scout will live so that he reflects well on his home, his church, his school, his friends, and himself. May the white of your badge remind you to live with honor. The second responsibility of an Eagle Scout is loyalty. With loyalty, all character lacks direction. Without loyalty, all character lacks direction. An Eagle Scout is loyal with his ideals. An Eagle Scout is loyal with his family, friends, and his community. May the blue of the Eagle Badge inspire your loyalty. The third obligation of Eagle Scout is courage. Courage gives all character, force, and strength. Trusting God and with faith in his fellow man, an Eagle Scout can face each day unafraid and seek his share of the world's to do, his world's work to do. Let the red of the Eagle Badge stand for your courage. The final obligation of Eagle Scout is service. Eagle extends a helping hand to those who still toil up the trail. The performance of a daily good deed takes on a new meaning when you enter a life of continued service to others. An eagle protects and defends the weak and helpless. He aids the unfortunate. He upholds the right to upholds the right for others. His code of action is based on real service. May the motto "Be prepared" always remind you that, as an Eagle Scout, you are the best prepared to be of service to others. May the watchful eye suspend. May the watchful eagle suspended from the ribbon remind you to perform service when opportunities arise.
The presentation of the Eagle Scout badge is an important and serious event. The climax and the goal for which a scout works many years, an occasion of pride and joy, a time for serious contemplation, is accumulation of efforts of the various leaders of the Scouts, as well as the Scouts themselves. The Eagle Scout Award is the highest and most coveted rank in Scouting, the last major step in the advancement program. At this point, we trust you have achieved our purpose in building of character, training of leadership, and practice of serving. May I have Phillip Stevens, one of our fellow Eagle Scouts, please step forward. And he will tell you the requirements of the Eagle Scout rank.
Hi, so as he said, my name is Phillip Stevens. I'm a fellow Eagle Scout here in Troop 417. I've known Tyler the whole time I've been in this troop, and I've also known him through marching band, as he was one of the first people I knew there. So I'm happy to be here today. So the requirements of an Eagle Scout, there are 7 requirements, but of course, in order to get to this point, you have to achieve the other ranks. And once you get to the rank of life, that's when you start working on these. The first one, be active in your troop and patrol for at least 6 months as a life scout. Demonstrate scout spirit by living the scout oath and law in your everyday life. Earn 21 merit badges, including the 13 that are Eagle required. Serve actively in an approved position of responsibility for a period of 6 months after becoming a life scout. Plan, develop, and lead others in carrying out a service project worthy of an Eagle Scout. Take part in a Scoutmaster conference. And finally, appear before a board of review of prominent persons and satisfy them that you have done your best to understand and live up to the Scout Oath and Law and always qualify for the Eagle Scout Award. I'd like to invite Mr. Margard up here.
Thank you, Phillip, and apologies in advance, I'm fighting a little cough. My name is Vern Margard. I'm former Scoutmaster of Troop 417. I'm a member of the Troop Committee with a particular portfolio of overseeing the advancement of our Scouts. As part of that role, one of my special duties, and the one that is really most meaningful to me today, is that of the Eagle Coach. It's my responsibility, it's my honor, to be able to work with our life scouts as they take those final steps from life to eagle. And it's been a pleasure and an honor to work with you, Tyler, and I'm honored to be able to participate in your celebration today. Part of the special responsibility that I have is the opportunity to be able to officially open and convene this Eagle Court of Honor on behalf of Scouts BSA. Careful examination has been made of the Eagle by this Eagle Court of Honor as to Tyler's qualifications to earn the Eagle Scout Award. Proficiency in the various crafts and skills prescribed for the Eagle Scout rank have been checked, and the records of the merit badges that Tyler has earned have been approved and certified by counselors approved by Scouts BSA. Scout candidate Tyler Reed has demonstrated his capacity and willingness to exert leadership in activities that are constructive and worthwhile in this community. The record's been checked of his troop leadership, school affairs, and in other fields of work and service, including here in this church. He's demonstrated loyalty and duty to God and country. He's qualified to receive the rank of Eagle Scout. And Tyler, I'll ask if you would please escort your parents up. And Mr. Campbell, if you would assist. And we now proclaim to all of the world Tyler's accomplishment in becoming an Eagle Scout. The symbol of your success as an Eagle Scout is the Eagle Scout badge and neckerchief, which will now be presented to your parents by Mr. Campbell. Your parents, in turn, will pin the badge on your uniform over your heart and place the neckerchief around your neck. Now, this is a very special part for me. This is the part where we get to recognize the parents. As the parent myself of two Eagle Scouts, I know a little bit about parenting Eagles. It's not an easy task. And we are deeply indebted to all of the parents of our Scouts for the work they do, whether they do it in uniform or whether they do it in home. They're a critical part of the success of becoming an Eagle Scout. Tyler, in recognition of the wisdom and guidance given to you by your father, please present to him the Eagle pin, which he'll be proud to wear in your honor. And now, also in recognition of the many hours of patient guidance given by her in your efforts, please pin the Eagle Mother's pin over your mother's heart. Tyler, I'm going to ask you to embrace your parents, and then I'll ask your parents to have a seat. No, you don't get to go. No. Let's you get go. To stay. No, not that easy. Not that easy. Now, the Eagle Scout candidate, Eagle Scout, will now take the Eagle Scout pledge. And as Tyler takes this pledge for the first time, I'd ask those Eagle Scouts in attendance if you would please stand. I'd like you to each, if you would please, loudly and clearly introduce yourself. Let us know when you earned your Eagle Scout Award and where. My name again is Vern Margard. I earned my Eagle Scout Award in 1972 from Troop 156 in Linworth, Ohio.
Campbell, 2008 from Troop 417. Logan Smith, 2021 or 22. I don't remember. I should have probably
Logan, we have a few more of these ceremonies coming. You'll have an opportunity to practice. Gentlemen, if you would please make the scout sign, and I will ask to just have Tyler repeat after me. On my honor, I will do my best.
On my honor, I will do my best.
To do my duty to God.
To do my duty to God.
On my honor, I will do my best.
On my honor, I will do my best.
To do my duty to my country.
To do my duty to my country.
I reaffirm my allegiance.
I reaffirm my allegiance.
The three promises of the Scout Oath.
To the three promises of the Scout Oath.
I thoughtfully recognize.
I thoughtfully recognize.
And take upon myself.
And take upon myself.
The obligations and responsibilities.
The obligations and responsibilities.
Of the rank of Eagle Scout.
Of the rank of Eagle Scout.
On my honor, I will do my best.
On my honor, I will do my best.
To make my training an example.
To make my training an example.
And make my rank and influence.
To make my rank an influence.
Strongly count for better scouting.
Strongly count for better scouting.
And for better citizenship.
And for better citizenship.
In my troop.
In my troop.
In my community.
In my community.
And in my contact with other people.
And in my contact with other people.
Regardless of race, color, or creed.
Regardless of race, color, or creed.
And to this I pledge my sacred honor.
To this I pledge my sacred honor.
Eagle Scouts in the audience, you may please be seated. Congratulations. Mr. Campbell?
So one thing that's not in the script that Tyler painstakingly wrote is there is another step that is beyond Eagle rank. And that is when you complete additional merit badges and show extended leadership in the troop. So I would like to present Tyler with the bronze palm for completing an additional 5 merit badges and showing leadership in the troop. And now, Tyler, you may be seated. Yes, yes, he will. It's all about him today, so of course he'll be back. So I charge you to enter the Scout or Eagle Scout Brotherhood, holding ever before you, without reservation, the ideals and honor of service. By representing or repeating the Eagle Scout pledge before your fellow members, you have become an Eagle Scout. Through the words you used just now are similar to those that you used in scouting. Today they mean more than you ever could before or at any time in the past. When you pledge yourself on your sacred honor using the same words that are found at the end of the Declaration of Independence, you sealed your internal loyalty to the Code of Eagle Scout. Now, before Tyler comes back up to give his closing remarks and to award his mentor pins, I would like Charlie Reed to come forward to say a few words.
Wow, this is surreal. 10 years in the making. A little over 10, almost 12. I just have some words of thanks. Thank you all for being here today. And those of who are online watching, thank you for attending online. Nancy Stevens, thank you for chipping in and offering to take some pictures. That's very helpful. Thank you. Pastor Kevin, thank you for hosting us here today and for receiving Tyler's Eagle Scout project here. Thank you very much. To the Scouts of Troop 417, I absolutely love seeing how all of you help each other succeed. To Mr. Margard, thank you for being a wise and patient Eagle advisor. Mr. Campbell, our Scoutmaster, thank you so much for your sacrifice and your dedication and your hard work. You work endlessly for these Scouts, and it'll have lasting benefit for them throughout the rest of their lives. Lynn Murdoch and the 417 Committee, thank you for all of your hard work behind the scenes to make this troop what it is. And also thank you to the rest of the adult leaders. I also want to say thank you to all of the friends and family who are part of this event today. All of those people that I just mentioned helped get Tyler to where he is today, and I want to say thank you for being our village. Tyler, thank you for bringing me along on this journey. Your first time camping was also my first time camping. It was the Cub Scout fall camp out. It was at Chief Logan Reservation. You were in the second grade. You were seven. And it got below freezing that first night. We both woke up the next morning frozen to the core. There were tears. Not going to say who. I thought, oh man, this scouting thing is not going to last long. But fortunately, I was wrong. Tyler, take a look at yourself and everything that you have accomplished and the man you have become. I am so proud of your heart and what you have done. I'm so proud of you. It's every parent's dream to see their child be more and do more and learn more than they do. And you're doing exactly that. And it is wonderful to see. I'm excited to see what your bright future holds for you, and I could not be prouder of you. And I'll finish with this. You are such a great mentor and influence to your brother, Jackson. Despite the fact that you know all of his buttons and press them frequently, he looks up to you more than you know, and he is eager to follow in your footsteps. And that's wonderful. That's truly wonderful. In just 1 year since he's been in this troop, he's advanced 2 ranks, and he has plans to be up on this stage just like you. So I'm proud of you too, Jackson. Congratulations again, Tyler. Thank you all for being here. Let's take a look at Tyler's path to Eagle.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. And the world. Stop me.
Thank you.
Dad, that was something else. Thank you. Hi, everyone. Thank you for being here. I appreciate it. I've worked for years to achieve this, and it does feel really good, I will say. But it has been a lot of hard work, and I would not have been able to do it alone. All the merit badges I've earned, all the popcorn I've sold, requirements I've completed would not have been possible without help. You guys are the reason I was able to do this, all of you. The troop, my family, my fellow scouts, everyone. I especially want to thank Mr. Fisher and Mr. Campbell for supporting me since the very beginning. If both of you wouldn't mind joining me up here. Mr. Campbell, I remember my first summer camp at Seven Ranges, which I'm glad I only had to go to once, where you helped me earn my first, you helped me earn my very first totenship, which if you guys don't know what that is, it's basically, the totenship is basically a scout's license to use pocket knives, axes, saws, stuff like that. And I wish I could say I still had the first card that I got, but it's been gone for years, I'm sure. I've always enjoyed our conversations, regardless of how unrelated to scouting they are. The amount of knowledge that you have about everything ever is astonishing to me. You always have the answers we need, and I know the troop appreciates that. But in all seriousness, thank you for having my back. Thank you for supporting me during my time as SPL and throughout the rest of my scouting career. I definitely, most certainly, could not have done it without you. That is why I'm giving you, I hope they're in this pocket, this mentor pin. Thank you for everything that you do. Thank you. For this troop.
You've done a lot more than I could.
I doubt that.
No, I'm not.
Mr. Fisher. You've been by my side since day one as well. Unfortunately for you, you've had to deal with the stupidity of Jed and myself since then. I'm very sorry. I remember going on Buffalo River trip with you and having you help me with requirements or whatever it was. I remember thinking how easy it was to get stuff signed off by you. I definitely enjoyed bonding with you on that trip. You've always been a friend, and I appreciate that. I've always felt like I can approach you with anything and not feel judged, unless I deserved it, of course. If I ever needed something, you always were the first person I went to, you and my dad, of course. Every camp out I think of where you attended, I can only remember the good times. For example, this camp out, the Buckeye Trail Campery in May 2019, we were building a bridge and cleaning up trails while you seemed to be enjoying a nice nap on a dolly. Yeah. Looks comfortable. But in all seriousness, we all appreciate what you do for the troop. You've been supportive ever since Judd and I were in Cub Scouts together. And because of all your help and support, I am giving you this mentor pin.
Thank you, Mr. Fisher.
And before Mr. Campbell, Mr. Fisher take the mic and share their thoughts if they so choose, I wanted to thank a few more people. Logan and Jed, I've always looked back on our friendship together and through scouting and been so happy at what we've accomplished together. No matter how many times we've roasted Logan, I've always felt we've had a tight friendship. And I was also always super thankful for that. I always knew I had friends by my side. Thank you, guys. And Logan and Phillip, through marching band, I've just become so much more close to you guys, and it's been the best. Max and Connor, I don't think we became super close until C-Base this past summer, and that will by far be my most memorable scouting trip, thanks to you guys, thanks to Wesley and Justin and Peter, who were, even though Peter's from 555. Max, I don't think I'll ever forget Anchor Watch with you and watching movies at 2 a.m., trying not to laugh and wake everyone up while we periodically glance up at the monitor to make sure we're not drifting off course. And thanks to you guys for being amazing scouts and overall wonderful people. I'll always remember that trip. and everyone else. I couldn't have done this without any of you, and I would name everyone by name and say thank you and list off the things that you've done for me, but we'd be here for a while. All of you have been amazing, and you've made my scouting experience one to remember, and I've enjoyed being with all of you. I hope you all continue to exceed in scouts and in life. Thank you, guys. Last one. All right. My parents. I would not be where I am if both of you hadn't been by my side. Mom, you've always been so helpful from behind the scenes, always making sure I'm on time to meetings, making sure I have everything I need for campouts, sharing my popcorn order form with your friends so I get more sales. Everything you've done for me has made me who I am today. Thank you. And Dad, while Mom has been behind the scenes, you've been on the front lines, attending campouts with myself and my brother, and you joined the committee to continue to help not just me, but the whole troop. You've always pushed me to work harder, and I thank you for that. I'm grateful you got to go to Seabase this past summer with us, and it would not have been as fun without you. Thank you for everything that you do. All right, Mr. Campbell, Mr. Fisher, the mic is open to you guys if you want to say a few words. Once you're done, Jackson's going to come up and call the flags for retirement, and then Pastor Kevin's going to come up and close us in prayer. Thank you, guys.
Wisdom first.
Tyler, it's been a privilege to be a part of your journey, to watch you grow and to watch you achieve. You know, many of those sleepless, cold camping nights, you wonder why you're out there and whether or not you're making a difference. And your recognition today is so much appreciated, to know that somehow you make that difference even if you're taking a nap.
Congratulations.
Yeah, Tyler, your entire career in Troop 417 has been an honor, as long with all the other scouts that I've been really grateful to be a leader for. First off, Mr. Reed, thank you so very much for the picture proof that Tyler did not learn how to sew. Yeah, I know. Problem with patch magic is it leaves a horrible residue. Well, that one's going to be changing here right after the meeting, is it not? Okay. But Tyler, you have helped so many scouts along your journey and been a great leader, been able to help other senior patrol leaders understand their job as well as help relieve some of the stress from it. So you've done a lot more work than I did during your term. Thank you. Okay, now if I can have Jackson come up and call colors.
Okay. I'm short. Will the audience please rise? Audience, attention. Color guard, attention. Color guard, forward march. Color guard, halt. Color guard, prepare to retrieve the colors. Color guard, retrieve the colors. Color guard, reform. Color guard, retire the colors. Color guard, halt. Color guard, at ease. Audience, at ease. Color guard, dismissed. You may be seated.
but I feel like we left something out. And that was, we have yet to just take a moment and together applaud and congratulate you. And so we're going to do that right now. Tyler, thank you for allowing all of us to share in this scouting journey. More importantly, thank you for allowing us to share in your life. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for your faithfulness throughout this scouting journey and for continuing the good work that you began in Tyler when he received Jesus to be the Lord and Savior of his life. Father, I praise you and I lift up everyone who's invested so wisely in Tyler's life, his parents, his brother, his grandparents, and his entire family, his scout leaders, and every scout Tyler has served shoulder to shoulder with, for his church family, his teachers at school, coaches, mentors, his friends, and each person who's impacted and helped to shape his life. May today be a special reminder to them as well that who we are shapes who others become and often encourages and inspires them to new horizons and even greater heights. Father, help us to leave this place with a renewed sense of your goodness, faithfulness, and ever-loving kindness towards Tyler and all of us, that we would willingly and cheerfully join you in the work that you're doing in us, in others, and throughout the world. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Tyler and his family and his scout leaders would like to thank all of you for coming and sharing in this Eagle Scout Court of Honor. And they'd invite you just to stay and to greet them right out these doors in our hallway for some light refreshments and some fellowship together. Thanks for coming.